identity. These are for all my trans friends. It has literally.
Okay, now I've seen this form on both TikTok and Twitter, so we're gonna talk about it. So this is very obviously a piece of Epic software, probably Epic My Chart, filling out forms before you go in to see a doctor. These fields are referred to in the biz as SOGI fields, sexual orientation and gender identity. There was a long battle to get these fields included in medical records so that we could measure differences in health outcomes for the LGBTQ community. You'll notice there are three sex and gender related fields: legal sex, gender identity, and sex assigned at birth. That's so that the system can bill properly. The legal sex is really meant to be the sex related to your insurance. Gender identity, because we should have that. And then sex assigned at birth, because doctors think about sex assigned at birth, and that's how they're taught to structure their like thoughts and diagnostic processes. There's a bit of controversy around that drop-down form, and calling out transgender female as a gender identity.
Hi TikTok, my name is Gina. I was just on twitch.tv/Niachu, and I'm gonna be going through my favorite Twitch comments. And this is me, by the way, just in case you were wondering who I was.
I sure can't wait for the video titled "Naked Gushing Over Women."
Color purple, I agree, I agree. Oh, she's whore.
I can solve a Rubik's Cube. Please be my Valentine.
I'm down.
I apologize for breathing her air.
The bisexual haircut, yum.
Nikki, suck up your feels and watch the damn thing.
Pretty and funny? I know, shocking. Big booby goddess, Jay Schlatt. I don't know what the fuck you're looking at, but okay.
Hi, girl in this video. If you see this, I am free today and would like to hang out. If you would like to hang out, I am free today. When I am free to hang out, I am free to hang out today. So if you want to hang out today, I am free.
Ayo, she mad fine.
Okay, so let me get this straight. You can put literal infants right out of your vagina into a shirt that says ladies man, and you can have board games called Life that's all about getting married to either your wife or husband and having children and being the perfect housewife and all this stuff. You can have the fucking bee movie where a male bee falls in love with an actual fucking woman, but the moment that gay people just exist, it's shoving sexualities down your throat. Carry the two and just write homophobia on your face. That would be a lot more simple.
If you aren't going to try and understand my pronouns, I'm not going to try and understand football, okay? Who are the Chiefs? What is a line of scrimmage? I don't care. Go eat your Totino's pizza rolls and say out of my life, you transphobic turd.
Yeah, because I'm a TV genius. Whenever people talk about queer versions of The Bachelor and The Bachelorette and they always are like, oh, but then other people can sleep with each other, like, what if they fall for each other? First of all, this is reality TV, we live for the drama, right? But second of all, we can do better. Right, The Bachelor is straight, all the women are bi. Lesbian version of The Bachelorette, in which none of them know who is The Bachelorette. All their contestants, they're all living in the same house, they're all getting to know each other, but one of them is responsible for deciding who goes home each week, and they don't know who. Version where everyone is genderqueer, but only one person a week is allowed to wear a button-down. I just think that one would be funny. A version of The Bachelorette, in which The Bachelorette is a black woman, and the contestants are all white women. She's not actually looking for love, she's in on it, and every week we as the audience just guess which white woman will commit the most microaggressions.
New rule, if you are non-binary, a switch, or bisexual, you are exempt from making any decision. Someone's like, where do you want to go eat? You're like, I don't have to decide. I'm non-binary, thank you.
Welcome to another episode of... I spoke to my grandma about how my wife and I are looking for a donor to make a baby, maybe this year, I don't know. And she asked me if it made me angry that my wife and I couldn't just make babies the good old-fashioned way. And I told her, yeah, it does kind of suck that we can't do that, but when I was younger, I was pretty cool with the no accidental baby for me, so it evened out. There's nothing wrong with it, but being a straight person seems so stressful. I was like, I can't imagine going to a party as a straight person. Maybe I'm 20 years old, I meet a nice guy, we fool around, and whoops, we accidentally made a family? Why is that a possibility? Like, I don't know anything about this person, and now we're bonded for life, and it's like, then I learned they want to be a SoundCloud rapper for a living. Do I have to support that now? For the baby? And she goes, I don't know what SoundCloud is.
Any movie or TV show clips that immediately changed a little part of you and gave you that self-growth?
Do you know what asexuality is? It's when someone has no sexual attraction to any sex or gender. Sex just doesn't do it for some people. But I still want to fall in love. Well, some asexual people still want romantic relationships, but they don't want the sex bit. And others don't want either. You know, sexuality is fluid. Sex doesn't make us whole. And so, how could you ever be broken?
What's wrong with me? Why do I feel like this?
Okay, no, fuck this. I don't want pronouns anymore. From now on, the only way that you should be addressing me when I come into a room is by saying, "You there, friend or foe?"
It's especially weird that gender-neutral fashion is so drab and uninspiring, when most of the non-binary people I know dress like, and I mean this in the nicest possible way, acid trip children's TV presenters.
I know, but hey!
A majority of the Young Avengers are not straight, and I don't really care if you don't like that. Teddy Ulkman, aka Hulkling, he is gay. Billy Kaplan, aka Wickham, also gay. Miss America, aka America Chavez, lesbian! Tommy Shepard, aka Speed, is bisexual. Marvel Boy, aka Nova, bisexual! Prodigy, better known as David Allen, that's right, another bisexual man. Kid Loki, a shapeshifter, is not only gender fluid, but bisexual. I'm now going to list off the minority. Patriot, Eli Bradley. Vision, Jonas. Iron Lad, Nate Richards. Stature, Cassie Lang. Hawkeye, Kate Bishop. Straight. Is she?
Lawrence, I speak for the trans. Respect our names or we make plans.
I am the Lorax, and I speak for the bis. Talk shit about us, and we'll rip out your eyes.
I am the Lorax, I speak for the non-binaries. If you say there are only two genders, we will release the bees!
I am the Lorax, I speak for the pens. If you say we fuck pots, we will fuck you up just cause we can.
Tell me how you know your boyfriend won't cheat on you without telling me how you know your boyfriend won't cheat on you.
What are you doing?
Assembling the Temple of Anubis.
Hi, I'm Toe, and I'm a trans boy, and also an artist. Well, anyways, my parents are not really supportive, so I'm trying to raise money with my art, so I can pay for my t-shirts and my surgeries. It's okay if you can help me with money, but if you could please just drop a like, follow me on TikTok or Instagram, it would really mean the world to me. I'm so excited to have my real body. Thank you so much.
Today I've been thinking about the most humiliating but probably funniest moment of my entire life. Early in my senior year, I was hanging out with a couple friends late at night, drinking water. And included in this group of friends were this guy who made me feel like complete shit, made fun of me all the time, was probably straight but called me the F-slur ironically, and an ex-girlfriend who I still very much had strong feelings for. Now, because I had no self-respect and was a little intoxicated, at one point I started making out with the guy who made me feel like shit. So anyway, we're laying on the ground, he's on top of me making out, and at one point he gets up a bit and goes, "You kiss really weird." He announces this to everyone. And from a few feet away, my ex goes, "Yeah." And he says, "You suck on the bottom lip too much." And she goes, "Yeah, he does." She crawls over to him and starts making out with him. My ex and my bully are making out on top of me. I am trapped underneath them. This goes on for a couple minutes.
Yesterday I asked the question, where have gay people been for the last 5,000 years? And the answer is everywhere! And for our first look into LGBT history, we're gonna look in Mesopotamia, since most high school world history classes start here anyway. It's a really solid place to start, there's a lot of ancient human civilization here. In the ancient Sumerian creation myth, the fertility goddess Ninma created all forms of human beings, some having all different types of genders, or third genders, or no genders at all, so people who are created outside of the gender binary have been around since the start. And most modern scholars agree there is something going on between Gilgamesh and Enkidu. The Epic of Gilgamesh is one of the oldest mythologies we have in human history, and Gilgamesh was a very powerful king. He was two-thirds god, and Enkidu was created to keep him in check. You see, Enkidu was a wild man who was described as having hair all over, you know, typical for a bear. They were described as being made specifically for each other and that the relationship was more fulfilling than any wife ever.
Specializing in conversion therapy, we return homosexuals to healthy heterosexual lifestyles.
Why would you go do that?
We believe that homosexuality is curable, though some find pleasure in it. Homosexuality is an addiction. An addiction that tears families apart.
I have a gay son. Never have to worry about him impregnating some skanky neighborhood slut, bringing home her unplanned for half-breed. I wish I'd known I was gay back then. I could have risen high in any one of the many fields dominated by gays. Entertainment, politics, broadcasting, tennis.
Poll questions for the group chat. They think they're the main character, but they are actually the background character queer teens hyperfixate on. Why would you ever care? The actual main character. Who do you bring home to the fam? Beautiful, wonderful, perfect. Who is absolutely not meeting the parents? Who has one brain cell that bounces around in their skull, occasionally hitting a corner for one coherent thought? Not a question of if, but when, they're rich and famous. Most likely to unknowingly join a cult. They think we don't know they're an immortal SMH. A killer. Who's getting a sugar daddy? Now from the top, make it drop. Who's gonna be the sugar daddy? Playboy Bunny was happening. Supreme nerd, all hail. You'll never
see it come. Hi, I'm Helen.
And I'm Willie.
And we're a fully heterosexual couple.
So it's Valentine's Day, a super special day for most people, but not really us, because it's about the same, honestly.
Because we're super, super in love!
Right.
But to make it special for you guys, we thought we'd tell you the story of how we first met.
So it all started at Quincy's Questioning Camp for the Confused.
Hey! Oh, I really like your shirt!
Oh, thank you! I wear it all the time.
No, seriously, I really love your whole ensemble.
Okay, seriously, that's all it takes to be my friend. Okay, come on, let's go make fun of the horse girls.
Okay! Man, I really hate my dance class. Nobody will let me help them stretch.
And I really hate my woodworking class. It's more work and less wood than expected.
Switch places? Willie, are you okay?
Yeah, I fell.
Here, I gotcha.
Okay. Oh my god, you guys, they're holding hands! Are you guys dating so we can finally send you home?
Yes.
Huh. In hindsight, that camp was kind of weird.
Anyway, happy Valentine's
Wait,
Day!
Wait, was that conversion camp?
My indigenous queer ancestors were murdered by white settlers only for me, as an indigenous queer person, to be called straight by white trans
After
people.
Having elders forced into assimilation of white settler gender systems,
this
and
feels
sexuality.
Kinda weird to be told what is queer.
My last moment as a human being with boobs, big boobs, spent ranking my favorite Taylor Swift albums. I got top surgery November 2019, and when they rolled me into the operating room, I had been told that it would be like a put on the anesthesia type of thing and like countdown from 10. And I was laying there with the thing on my face, talking to the doctors, and I thought we were just like having a conversation. And they're like, you like music? And I'm like, yeah. They're like, oh, who's your favorite artist? And so fucking obviously, I'm like, Taylor Swift. And they're like, oh, you got any favorite songs or anything? I'm just laying there and I'm like, I think her debut album like really did it for me. I started being a Taylor Swift fan when I was like really young, like I was like 6, and like that album, like I'm country at heart, that album like really did it for me. The Fearless era really like kind of defined those years for me, but Red, it struck me like a goddamn truck. All Too Well.
Stories from inside my closet. In here. Wow, you play the piano. Yeah, since I was 6. That's really cool. What did you want to show me? Well, I've been struggling to put this into words, so maybe this will work instead. Wow. That was amazing. I'm glad you liked it. So, a few weeks ago, I was helping my sister move into her college dorm. I was carrying her storage bin when it slipped and landed on my foot. The doctor told us that my foot was broken and would need surgery soon. It's not a serious surgery, but I will be on crutches for a while. How long will you be out of school? Actually, I was planning to not miss any school, because then I wouldn't have to miss seeing my lab partner every day.
I don't understand straight people. Like,
What do y'all even do?
Friend group with the same aesthetic. It's always all of them gotta look like that one Tumblr post.
Tell me why my friends actually look like this, though. This is Tom, Kaylin, and Selena.
I am too big for my shirt. This is for all my little queers who were never taught how to tie a tie. I'm your dad now. Okay, so first things first, there's a beefy end and a little end. You want to make sure the beefy end is like twice as long as the little end. And I personally like to make my knot where they become kind of the same size. So you're going to take the beefy end and pull it over to the side, okay, in a straight line. And then you're going to bring it back behind the little end, back to the side again. And then you're going to pull it over one more time, okay? And then you're going to flip it back over like that. Okay, and then you'll notice you made like a little pocket. So you're going to tuck the beefy end in the little pocket and pull it through. When you pull on the beefy end, you can adjust the size of the knot. And when you pull on the little end, you adjust how long it is. Excuse me. So yeah, that's how you tie a tie. I hope you guys have a good day. Send this to a queer who needs it. I love you. Have a... Yep. Yeah, nice. Cool.
Fuck. Okay. Okay.
Hey, Dad.
Yeah.
I have something to tell you. I'm not mentally stable enough to actually have a conversation about it. So I'm going to tell you, you're not going to respond. I'm going to go to my room, and we're not going to talk about it unless I bring it up. Sound cool?
Maybe.
Cool. I'm trans, I've known for a while, it's been eating me up, so I have to tell you, Mom, the letter that I wrote Mom that I told you about is telling her the same thing, because I can't take hearing it from her mouth that I'm a disgusting abomination. Bye, I love you, I gotta go to my room now, I'm gonna have to go.
She's always gone, 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 oh, in the night she hears it calling, in the night she's dancing to.
Okay, hear me out. Childhood Egypt phase to being gay pipeline.
What's your favorite gay TV show or movie moment?
One of you will now be allowed to leave the game. The rest of you will be staying here with me forever. You have Blazzle Hooches to write down your choice for who should get to escape on the screen in front of you. Go!
Well, Bob, I voted for Allura.
Who did you vote for?
I selected Pidge. She and her family have the best chance of rebuilding what my father started.
Interesting. Lance, who got your vote?
I voted for Keith. He's our leader, plus he's half Galra, so I think he's, like, the future.
Keith, the leader, who do you think deserves to make it out of here, huh? Lance? Why Lance?
I just don't want to be stuck here for eternity with Lance.
Aw, thanks, man. Wait, what? We're dead.
Hi, y'all. Today we are going to talk about the different methods for taking your gender-affirming hormones. Alright y'all, first thing we're going to talk about is testosterone gel. Pros of testosterone gel. It's very simple. You apply it daily. There's very little side effect. It is transdermal, which means it absorbs through the skin, so it is just as effective as doing injections. The cons of doing testosterone gel. One, some people can get a little bit of local skin irritation. Some people might be a little allergic. I don't see that very much. Two, it is applied daily. And three, and most important, it can transfer to other people and to clothing. Wash your hands thoroughly. Stay tuned for more information on gender-affirming hormone therapy.
Every LGBT friend group chat has the BDSM test results or the rice purity test results, usually at the same time. Oversharing on trauma. Undersharing on or laughing off trauma. Proclamations of love. Pictures of cute frogs and cute stuffed animals, incomprehensible strings of letters, one very serious discussion of politics a month, communism chanted several times over, plans for vacations none of us will ever actually go on, picturesque pictures of the countryside, and personality test results because none of us actually know ourselves and long to be perceived.
Hello, it is I, your local closet gremlin. I have decided to single-handedly create the world's worst audiobook. I am officially on T as of last Friday, and starting tomorrow, I will be reading one chapter of Les Mis for the internet every day for the next 373 days during my transition. For those who are curious, the introduction of the Barricade Boys will be on day 182, which should be early August. And until then, I will be on my YouTube channel on a daily basis, link in the thing in my bio. But yes, come read Les Mis with me while my voice does things.
Listen, if you guys want to move around and shift your asses a little, it's okay. It's okay by us, right? You can take all your clothes off if you like too.
What matter?
Fuck off.
I want to let y'all know, I am actually friends with some straight men.
Max, were you offended by my video?
Of course not, TikTok user Haplomask.
Trying to achieve gender euphoria? Layers. Makeup woo? Shiny jewelry? Skateboard earring? More layers lol? Tiny fake plant? Hey! Socks and dogs.
Do you guys know that your body will literally tell you what it needs? All you have to do is listen to it.
Women. Black women, trans women, Asian women, white women, tall women, short women, thick thighs women, petite women. All women.
Give me the Gucci women.
Watch me make binder dogs while I talk to you. Yes, my family hates this voice, so of course I had to use it again. The support on this project has been overwhelming and I can't begin to thank you guys enough. I got two orders and a donation that I will cherish forever. I have also gotten told things like how I used the LGBT plus pass to get clout on here, which is like, what the fuck? I feel like it is also important to mention that these dogs do not have to come with zippers. It is just a choice I made so that the dogs can be reused instead of thrown away. Now let's pray I don't burn my fingers a bajillion times like the last dog. All finished. These two are named Pedro and Philippe.
They call themselves the Guardians of the Galaxy.
What a bunch.
Watch the algorithm at work whenever I post a video, because at first, I'll get like a lot of dissenting opinions that don't really have any backing, and I'll ask them like, okay, well, please explain yourself. Why do you feel this way? And they're like, blah, 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 you fucking idiot, you're so dumb. Blah, blah. And I'm like, okay, cool. But then all of a sudden, it's like throughout the day, less and less and less hateful idiots will come into my comments, and less 14-year-olds with anime fan pages will be commenting, being like, I should be able to be included in a sexual conversation. And then it's just adults that are queer that are like, oh my god, thank you for saying this. I'm so tired of having to educate 13-year-olds. By the way, I am not only the CEO of deleting comments, I'm also the CEO of blocking minors, because you don't belong here. Go watch dancing videos and, like, I don't know, ASMR on YouTube.
Wait, you're getting top surgery? But I thought you were a bottom.
I remember when I came out as bisexual to my dad, and his response was, okay, you're attracted to boys and girls. Everybody is at that age. So was I. And I was like, who's gonna tell him? I can't, because I need a home. But like, somebody gotta inform him.
What's a video that lives in your head rent-free?
You're a football player. It's in your blood. That's racist. Your soul. That's racist. Your eyes. That's gay. That's homophobic. That's black. That's racist. Damn.
One day, you're gonna say it wrong. You're gonna say it wrong. No, you.
Amanda, excuse me.
I knew it. Here, I'm gonna die.
I actually do have a boyfriend now. I met him while protesting downtown this summer. And of course I didn't tell my parents that that's what I was doing. But every single day, I'd be like, oh, I'm just going to hang out with Joe. And then we'd carpool. But you do that every single day for a whole summer. And my mom started to be like, oh, so who's this Joe guy? And you're like, no, is he the new boy? And I was like, no, mom. And then like 2 weeks later, I was like, touche. Touche. He's great. He's a straight man. But he willingly introduces me to his friends, to his conservative bandmates, as his boyfriend. So let's just break down what that means. He says, this is my boyfriend Diana, and then they see me, and then he explains nothing. I love him very much.
All right, come over here, sir. I gotta pat you down.
Can I actually get, like, a female officer to do this?
According to our policy, it has to be the same sex. I'm sorry.
Yeah, I know it's confusing, but I am female, so.
Oh, I'm sorry. Trisha, I need a female officer. Yes?
Bell. Jake! Come here. You're charged with high treason, Tank. Are you guilty or not guilty? Guilty?
Okay, so in 2009, I started high school. I was having an identity crisis, and I legally... I changed my middle name on Facebook to Danger, because if you weren't on Facebook in 2009, people would just change their names to goofy stuff, and I changed it to Danger, and I left it that way, and people started calling me that in real life, and sometimes they'd be like, is that really your middle name? And I'd be like, yeah. But now, I think it would actually be very cool and trans of me to stop using my masculine middle name and become Dakota Danger. Should I legally change my middle name to Dakota Danger?
Last night I mocked up a binder bodice inspired by the Wood Mother. Gonna tag them down below. But I'm doing mine a little bit different than they did there, so I'm gonna show you what I'm doing. Also, that's my dad's band. I'm altering this thrift store pattern, just the bodice bit. So the biggest thing is these curves here are like what's supposed to form the tit pocket, but we don't want that because we don't want any tit. So we are going to fold that to create a perfectly straight seam over the breast. And then we have the back piece, which I also folded in to fit me better, and that makes our armpit hole. So this is the shape we end up with. This is the back. We've got this nice curve here. It's gonna be fastening in the front where I'm gonna be putting some eyelets, but not with this one. Let's look at the real fabric. All right, so it's gonna be reversible. We have this gorgeous thick blood orange cotton and then this fruit print. So here at the binding seam, you're really gonna wanna make sure you're going with the grain of the fabric and not on the bias. We don't want right here to stretch. Two, I'm sorry. No brows, just eyes to find out.
Welcome back to Where Have Gay People Been for the Last 5,000 Years. In today's episode, we're back in Mesopotamia. The Assyrians were one of the first cultures to actually have written laws against certain sexual behaviors. These laws give us good insight into how relationships were structured and viewed. Same-sex relationships, both male and female, were very common in ancient Assyria. But the Assyrians were very strict. For example, they never allowed anything that wasn't consensual. And there were laws banning people in the military from having relationships. And if you did, well, snip snap. However, there was nothing condemning consensual relationships between two people. There was a certain sense of hierarchy to these relationships, though. For example, it was a bad omen if two people of different classes had relationships with each other. Priests of the goddess Ishtar were known to change their names to female names and wear female clothes and adopt female gender norms when serving their god. Our next episode is China, so come stick around. Don't miss the episode.
But it makes less and less sense to cis people. Da 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 da. Bowling alleys. Roller rink. The party zone. Just this pattern in general, really. At my core, that is what my soul looks like.
We are for surely living in 2021 because my girlfriend gave me a Valentine's Day card, and that Valentine's Day card has a QR code on it, and the QR code is a folder of her nudes!
So, long story short, I'm planning on telling my family I'm trans tomorrow. And that's great and all, that'll go however it goes. Poorly, medium, it's not gonna go well, but, whatever, I'm prepared, okay? But what I want to know is, what goes on in their head that, they see me regularly, and they're just like, ah, yes, my wonderful, heterosexual cisgender daughter. And, regularly, I pull up to, the family gathering, and some tías there just like, ¿y el novio? No. No, you got the wrong guy here.
If you're at a loss as to what to call your non-binary friend, just remember that cum dumpster is a gender-neutral term.
If you're LGBT or non-binary, listen up. My name's Seth and I'm non-binary. I got sick of dating apps that ask whether I want to be shown with men or women, so I decided to create my own. It's called Prism. On Prism, you can pick whatever pronouns you want, and instead of asking who you want to be shown with, it just shows you people. And over time, it learns who you want to see and who wants to see you. And you won't get banned just for being trans. Tinder. If you like this idea, you can check out the app by clicking the link in my bio. And if you want to support, comment, like, or follow. I hope you enjoy and happy swiping.
I hate how God made me queer, a person of color, mentally ill and poor. It was like, baby, you don't need to pick, you just struggle.
Mostly what I do here is I pull bullets out of gangsters that have been shot. Yeah. That's like my number one thing.
In a way, I was kind of shot. Like, not shot really. My tits off.
I will admit it was my first time doing top surgery.
You did a great job. I don't think you left that much stuff in there that you shouldn't have. It's a little bit bumpy on this side, but I think it's sure. Kind of cool.
Well, I'm very excited to do it. You might imagine it's not a lot in my line of work. There's not a chance to prove I am a LGBT ally, so it's nice to be able to do that.
Yeah.
3, 2, 1, go. It's a good time to be drawing. What are we gonna draw today? Well, looky here again. Surprise, it's gay.
I'm gonna show you crush. I ain't gonna fucking guess. Maybe I should take
how it went when my aunt was telling my younger cousins that I'm now trans and go by he, him, and my name is now Zach. Hey, kiddos, we need to have a talk. What? Yes. Okay. Okay, mama. Do you remember your Auntie Pam's kid? Yes, ISIs? They're coming to visit us since it's been years. His name is now Zach, and he's transgender. Do you guys have any questions? Heal him pronouns. Yes. So Zach is like me? Yes, love. Always getting Jada
back around. Oh yeah, I'm non-binary. Oh my gosh, I'm NB too! Oh yeah, I actually don't really like that term. Isn't it so funny how we all have weird names like kangaroo or hairbrush? Oh, I haven't changed my name and I don't know if I will. And no shade to those names, but if I do, I'm not gonna choose one of them. Are you a frog NB or a possum NB? I mean, there's a possum that decided to live in my backyard, but that's more of an annoyance to my dog than anything else. And hey, I just said I don't like being called an NB. Your voice is so deep, how long have you been on T? I was assigned male at birth and went through testosterone puberty. You know we can be non-binary too, right? So you're not a possum NB?
At the risk of sounding very old man yells at cloud, I've seen a lot of young queer creators talk about our friend the Carabiner. Now we know that the Carabiner is significant to the sapphic community, but I've seen a lot of posts calling it things like the lesbian purse, and I want to talk about why it's significant. Carabiners used to be used as a form of flagging, much like the hanky code is still used today. When it was less accepted and even illegal to be queer and openly, you had to flag, you had to tell people that you were down in some way that was subtle, such as the carabiner or the hanky code. Butches particularly would wear the carabiner on their right or left hip to signify if they were down and also that they were a top or a bottom. There's some speculation why it was the carabiner. Some was because a lot of butch people were in blue-collar jobs, and some would say because it's a phallic symbol. And while it's wonderful that we're at a point where we don't have to use flagging to signify that we're queer anymore, such as the carabiner, we have to remember our history or else it'll be lost forever. My niggas
really
rock,
roll, control. I really don't support people with naturally blonde hair. It's not like it was my choice to be born naturally blonde. It's the same way with LGBT people. They were just born that way. Well, I just don't like it. They should be straight. It's just not normal. I mean, I could say the same thing about your teeth, but here we both are.
So I once had a student who asked if I had a girlfriend, and I was very straightforward, and I said, no, I'm actually gay, which means I don't like women, I like men. And he said, I don't believe you because of how much you like Taylor Swift. And I said, okay, that's different. That's a love of her music, not a romantic love. And he really stopped and he was reflecting and he was really thinking. And then he looked at me and he said, Mr. W. And I said, yeah? And he said, can we watch A Dog's Purpose in class today? And we did. So if you have not seen A Dog's Purpose...
You know, I do have to admit, after reviewing some of your references, it's pretty impressive, but I'm sorry, there's no room for bigotry at this company.
Bigotry? I am so far from bigoted. What are you even talking about?
What do you mean? I mean, it says right here under weaknesses that you're homophobic.
Oh, no, sorry. It's not homophobic, it's homophobic. I'm afraid of homophones.
Oh, that's so funny because they sound so similar, but they have such completely different meanings.
Oh my God, please stop, I'm begging you.
Let's go, lesbians, let's go! Let's go, lesbians, let's go! Here we go, lesbians. Here we go, lesbians, come on! Let's go, lesbians! Oh my God, lesbians. Lesbians, move out of my way!
Since people seem to be all up in their feelings about the Wickedness Speed video I did, let's talk about another LGBTQ character that Marvel announced is coming to the MCU. This is America Chavez. Now granted, I have my issues with the casting, because I mean, look at her and then look at how America Chavez is drawn, but that's a whole nother story. But yes, as I said in the beginning, and I wanted to put this here to piss people off, America Chavez is a lesbian. America Chavez is from an alternate dimension outside of time and space known as the Utopian Parallel, which is actually created by the Demiurge, which is a future version of Wiccan. Eventually, America Chavez will come into the main Marvel Universe and join the Young Avengers with the sole purpose of protecting Wiccan, as he is the future creator and ruler of her home dimension. America Chavez can fly, she is invulnerable, she has super speed, super strength, so this moment shows her picking up a Megalodon shark and throwing it pretty far. And Loki says if she wanted, she could hurl tanks to the moon. Her most unique ability is to open star-shaped portals to go anywhere in the multiverse or any dimension.
If you're pretty, stop. If you want to transition, stop. Just listen to me. I don't care what anybody ever tells you. Transitioning is not that expensive. You can do it the right way. And I do mean the right way. How? Well, it's kind of simple. Do a little research. Now, minus the fact that some people can't actually transition due to health concerns, does not invalidate that they are still not male. Now, here's how I did it. I went and talked to Planned Parenthood. I don't have health insurance. I told them I don't have health insurance. I said, that's okay, we'll put you on a sliding scale. This appointment's only gonna cost you $40. Wait, what, $40? Are you kidding me? That's great. So then, now I got prescribed tea. I started tea today for the first time. Cost me less than $100 to start tea, including needles and the testosterone. The pharmacy even helped me out by giving me a discount on my tea, as well as the needles. They do everything they can to help you. You gotta ask. So when you're ready, ask questions, get help.
Randall, there is a cow outside.
This is a cow farm. You're gonna find cows outside.
No.
Hello, Gay Book Talk. Tonight, my recommendation is going to be another no-shit Sherlock recommendation, and if you're new, my no-shit Sherlock recommendations, although this is only the second one that I have done, are recommendations that are pretty universally loved by queer readers. So basically, if you want somewhere to start, no-shit Sherlocks are good places. And that no-shit Sherlock recommendation is Aristotle and Dante Discover the Secrets of the Universe. One thing that I did not know before I started Aristotle and Dante is that it's actually set in the 1980s. And as you can see, it's won a lot of awards, which isn't surprising given the poetic nature of the prose and the timeless way that it reads. I have a feeling that this one is going to stand the test of time as far as books go. The characters are very flawed, very real, and very loving. And while I am actually kind of the opinion that every queer reader should give it a shot, there is a trigger warning for a gay bashing, and I understand if you want to skip it.
Well, that's fun. That's sticking out. You ever just watch something and think, wow, everyone in this is gay?
That's how I felt watching this movie. That's a fucking twink. That's a pansexual, if I've ever seen one.
That is a lesbian. That is a fucking lesbian. Look at that. That is a lesbian.
Goob looked like a homosexual man who made some bad decisions in his 20s. Have you ever met a bisexual that doesn't look like this? Gay. This hat was fucking gay. I don't know what to tell you. It was gay. Buddy, I don't know what you are, but you're sure as hell not cisgender. He was the exception. Have you ever seen a lesbian that doesn't look like this? That's a they-them-ass bitch right there. She was so gay. She was so gay. You cannot tell me that Tom Selleck looks fucking straight. You cannot tell me.
I have a very valuable piece of information that you will use at some point in your life. If you ever have to pee, but you cannot make it to a bathroom, scratch the back of your calf. Your brain cannot process your calf being stimulated and recognize your bladder at the same time. You're welcome.
My fucking God. These bitches gay. Good for them. Good for them.
And I will retire with the crown.
Yes.
No, I'm not lucky, I'm blessed.
Yes!
Clap for the heavyweight champ.
Me!
Jazz McDonald's, where our slogan is ba-da-ba-ba-ba-ba-da-ba-da.
Welcome to
Front Bottoms Taco Bell. She'll never love you back. And while you're wasting away, do you want nacho fries with that? Maybe someday we'll be better than all the mistakes in my past. But nothing gets me high like Baja Blast.
Where are those potatoes at?
This is for all the lesbians out there that have been told by a guy, you just haven't had the right one. I want you to send them this video. Hi, dude. I'm porn star Brie Olsen. I have been with hundreds of men. It's probably safe to say that they're bigger than you, more handsome than you, and can go a lot longer than you can. I've also dated men. Extremely wealthy men, kind men, much kinder than you. Men that had private jets, treated me like a princess. Men that maybe didn't make so much money, but still treated me so good and were so sweet. Extremely intelligent guys. The kind with a vocabulary that I'd have to look up every other word. And here I am, lesbian as fuck. She's gay, bro. If it were possible to change her, it sure as hell wouldn't be you.
All right, we are finally going to talk about this. So for those of you who don't know, Tchaikovsky and Saint-Saëns were two amazing romantic composers who both happened to be gay. Tchaikovsky is known more so than Saint-Saëns, but Saint-Saëns did go to Algeria for multiple trysts and did drag. So their friendship is interesting. The two met in 1875, and they hit it off very well. They were very fond of one another, so much so that they performed ballet for one another. Eventually, Saint-Saëns got wind that Tchaikovsky was writing a Romeo and Juliet overture piece. You know, the piece about forbidden love. And he was like, hey, wink, wink, nudge, nudge, I want to see you perform it in Paris. Please, premiere in Paris. Come on, come to Paris. And Pyotr Ilyich Gay Disaster Tchaikovsky said, no, I want to do this for Mother Russia. Also, this is so petty. No straight person is this petty. But even with that, they were still fond of one another, so much so that Saint-Saëns kept referring to Tchaikovsky as Secher Tchaikovsky, which translates roughly to this deer. And here is one of their letters.
Hello, my name is Hayden, and today I will be listing and explaining my top four least favorite gay movies of all time. First up at number four, we've got Naomi and Eli's No Kiss List. This movie was made in 2015, and you can definitely tell. I was just gonna have three movies in this list, but then my friend brought this movie up, and I was like, okay, yes, I do have to include this. So the movie stars Victoria Justice and this little gay man, and it's basically about their friendship. So they're best friends, but the girl, Naomi, is in love with him, and he is gay, and she knows this, but she like has this fantasy that they're gonna get married. It's just really gross, and it would be like more okay if the movie condemned it, but they don't really at all. They're like, oh yeah, this is fine. I haven't seen this movie in forever, so correct me if I'm wrong, but I think in the end she like comes to terms with it, but that's just really gross. I don't like it. It's just a gross movie, and the acting's really bad, and not in a good way, just bad movie.
queer and or from a small town and or have childhood trauma? Which song do you want to scream at 3 a.m.?
You are coming down with me, hand in unlovable hand, and I hope you die.
On my shoulders, collarbones begin to crack. There is very little left of me, and it's never coming back.
I could go off the deep end. I could kill all my best friends.
Wow. What would I do? Do I tape it? Glue it? Blue tack? What?
Oh, honey, no. Take it from a trans girl who has experience with this. Do not tape it. It will hurt. It is a bad idea. You come in with me.
We're in my room.
Okay, sweetheart. You're gonna need these. I'm gonna show you what is called tucking. There are many ways of doing it. This is my version because I have no money. And it's kind of safer. All I've done to make this is take a sock, cut the end off, and cut the bit that has the elastic on it, and make a hole. Take some tights, underwear, or boxers, and cut the waistline off. Boom. Take the sock, put it through. As you can see, I am pre-op. I apologize for everyone. Really skinny jeans, homemade gaff. So, penis goes back, testes go up, gaff on. People have thought I have-
And I can't get it out until I release it, so I'm making this. If gender is performance, then I'm on the tech crew.